I would recommend you start with a planner at the city. We have planners that staff our planner's desk in the Permit Application Center, City Hall on the third floor. You'll also have access there to building safety, fire department, and public works staff that you can ask about your proposed development. We're also available on the phone or email, so you can email in your questions. And we'll work with you on, okay, what are you proposing? What's your zoning? Is that use allowed? That's always the first hurdle. Can you do that on your property? And then we'll talk about the different development standards that apply. And a lot of those are in the zoning code, but some of them are fire code, building code, our public works design standards. So, you know, we can get into the minutiae with you or keep it high level depending on where you're at. We also offer pre-application conference for folks. So if they want to have a more detailed meeting with city staff and get written responses, that's an option for people to apply for that and have that kind of meeting as well. Yeah, it really depends on the level of development. If, for example, you're going to build a new building, I would say you need somebody that can do your plans for you, that's expert in that. If you're doing something that's a large commercial development, you're probably going to need engineering staff, your own private engineering staff, to do your stormwater calculations for you, you know, or an architect to do the design for you, make sure you're meeting the building code and the zoning code. So often people hire outside help, professionals to help them. If it's something smaller, like a shop or garage, maybe you're buying it prefab, then you don't necessarily need a design professional, even though you might need a building permit for it. We have information on how to what triggers a building permit, our fees, our process is all online that you can check out. I think the most common question we get from homeowners or folks that are buying a new house is fencing and sheds or shops. And so a lot of times people will say, I found out I don't need a building permit for my shed because it's 200 square feet or less. And that's true. But there are still zoning regulations that apply. And so we think that's what I want to emphasize. It's always important to call the planning desk and just make sure you didn't just get one piece of information, because there's still setbacks that apply, for example, and there's still height restrictions, and there's regulations that say how much of your backyard you can cover with a shop or a shed. The same with fencing. You can't put a really tall fence in your front yard. You can't have a, you know, 6 foot tall fence to block off your front yard. Well, you can have a fence in your front yard, but they have to be pretty short and you have to be able to see through them, you know, kind of think a traditional picket fence. And people sometimes question that and say, well, why do you care? Why does the city care? And so I say, well, it's not about any one individual property, but it's about the community walking down the street, right? And so you don't want to feel like you're in a kind of enclosed tunnel. If it's your backyard on a major street, that's different. There's different fencing regulations, so you can fence off your backyard for privacy on a major street. People also ask us to identify their property lines or intervene in disputes among neighbors over a fence. And so those are two things the city does not provide. We can give you information on the dimensions of your lot that might be helpful to you, but really a private surveyor is the only person that can help you identify where your property lines are. And we can give you resources on mediation for fence disputes and other things, but ultimately the city will not get involved.